So, welcome to our mini conference on nature ecology in Judaism, Christianity and Islam. The conference was actually meant to begin today in Oslo with many more participants, but unfortunately because of the coronavirus it couldn't take place. And so we were fortunate to have three speakers who agreed to present their papers at a Zoom mini conference. I want to start by saying a little bit about the importance of nature at the time of the coronavirus. As we all know, because we are in lockdown and are not supposed to go out too much, nature is much more empty right now. And the images you see here, those of you who are Londoners are perhaps able to identify these places because they are all taken, I took them in parks in London over the last weekend, especially Hampstead Heath. So here you can see one of the swimming ponds at Hampstead Heath, which last year was totally overcrowded, and now you can see that it's empty and no one is admitted. So the lockdown then has led to much less pollution and also to animals such as ducks and pigeons reclaiming their habitats. And there is also much more wilderness developing. And that is reminds me very much of what Abraham Joshua Heschel has said about the meaning of the Sabbath, namely that the Sabbath as a special day within the week is meant to let humans not interfere with creation, to stay away with from interfering with nature. And so in a way one could see this time of the coronavirus as a kind of extended sabbatical period for nature. The conference as a whole was meant to reflect on the ways in which nature is dealt with in religions. And we are focusing on the Abrahamic religions here, but this could also be expanded to other religions, for example, Asian religions. Papers were meant to deal with the perception of nature and human-nature relationships from the creation story onwards until nowadays, and also deal with ecology today. So one important aspect is the relation between humans and nature, how this relationship is determined in traditional religious texts. Are humans depicted as rulers over nature? And if so, does this imply that they can exploit nature for their own benefit and without limits? Or does it mean that they are supposed to care for the well-being of nature? A question which especially vegans have come up with is why should humans be considered superior to other created beings such as plants and animals? And what are the rights of non-human natural beings? So altogether, hopefully these studies will lead towards a new valuation and treatment of nature. And we have to, on the one hand, we can learn from traditional texts, but on the other hand, we might also have to take a critical stance to some of the statements we find in these texts and view them within their own historical, cultural, and environmental contexts. Our program today consists of three lectures, which are arranged chronologically, starting with the New Testament, then moving on to the Quran, and at the end dealing with the with nature and ecology in the Kabbalah. And some of you might wonder whether or why all of the speakers are male, and one of the speakers was actually already concerned about this. But the reason is that these are the three who had their papers ready and were willing to present. The conference also had female speakers, but the female speakers were not ready yet. So perhaps in the future, when we have more papers ready, we can have more of these mini conferences and then also include some female speakers. So I'm now going to introduce our first speaker, Professor David Hurrell, who is Professor of New Testament Studies at the University of Exeter in the UK and the Director of the Center for Bible Studies there. He has various, his research interest is focused on our topic, namely the Bible and its use in environmental ethics, and he has published and co-edited a number of books on this topic, for example, a book on ecological hermeneutics, biblical, historical, and theological perspectives, published by T&T Clark in 2010, and then also a very interesting book by the title Greening Paul, Rereading the Apostle in an Age of Ecological Crisis, and a book on the Bible and the environment towards a critical ecological biblical theology, which was also published in 2010. I look forward very much to hear his talk.